Welcome to Queens, New York, home to Citi Field, New York World's Fair, and a really neat company scaling larger and larger to catch up in size with its ambition and purpose. They are an urban mushroom farm, and they grow beautiful products that go from this to this.
We're on a very interesting homeschool field trip today. We're visiting an urban mushroom farm, and it's fascinating what they're doing here. So we're here with the kids. Let's go take a look at what's going on.
Go, 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 go.
Hey, Avram.
Hi, Patrice.
Good to see you. This is Avram, and he's from Mushroom Direct, and he's going to be giving us a tour of their urban mushroom factory. We're all very excited. The kids are absolutely stoked to see what goes on at a mushroom factory. So please, take us on your journey.
Sounds good. Let's begin with the mixing process. We're taking the agricultural waste, which could be wood or soy hulls, or making our own little mix. We mix it in our mixer, add some water, and we have a ready mix, which looks like this. We'll put it in a bag, it's prepared, and then we're gonna sterilize it, which will remove all the bacteria, all the fungus, all everything. So now it becomes a sterile block like this.
See,
it looks like it's cooked, fully cooked, nice and hot.
So when you say agricultural waste, where is this coming from?
It's like sawdust, you know, like when you cut wood, there's sawdust. Instead of throwing it out or burning it, they make it into a pellet.
Okay.
Which is pressurized wood, which we can reuse for the mushroom growing process.
So is this kind of like a soil of sorts for it to grow in?
Yeah, it's basically a medium, a substrate we call it.
A substrate. We're going to look that substrate. One up.
This is our laboratory. This is the cleanest room, positive pressure. This is where we take our sterilized bags.
Okay.
And we inoculate.
Meaning?
Which means the mycelium, the mushroom mycelium, the network. We put it into the medium that they can consume. They're going to grow inside it.
Okay.
So, come inside. There's no work right now. This is HEPA filters. They create airflow under which conditions we can work. This is a mushroom mycelium growing inside. You see the white fluffy stuff? All the white. It's a huge network. There's over a billion mycelium inside, which we then take and put it into another food source, which is in this case it's corn or any form of grain. And then we utilize this grain and we put it inside these bags, which then you see the white mycelium? They're beginning to grow like a network. And this little bit of piece is like a million of them network. And they're all interconnected. They basically share the food. And
so that goes from there to there?
Yes.
Okay.
It helps us replicate it faster. We open up each bag under the hood, sterile conditions, and we introduce the mycelium into the next medium.
The next stage. Okay. Next stage.
We have all sorts of mushrooms here. We have chestnuts, lion's mane, different types of oysters.
Down into the bowels of Mushroom Direct.
This is our dungeon.
Wow, this is cool.
This is our incubation room. This is where after the laboratory, we bring them here and they begin to colonize. Takes about a month. 3 weeks, you see how many of them are? They took over the entire bag.
Wow.
This is where we can identify if there's any contamination with other competitors, and so on.
So this is after you've combined the two in that room, under the hood, and then it comes in here.
Yes.
And this process takes place.
Correct.
Cool.
It's an incubation process. As you see, we have a stock full of substrate materials. Both grain spawn. This is the we took out. This is contaminated, so you can see.
Okay. How do you tell?
You can see a different strain is growing. It's green. We remove it immediately after it's been identified as not good to grow into.
And what do you what do you do with it? It just gets
We dispose of it, composting, and nature takes care of it.
Okay, beautiful.
You can see a pink oyster beginning to grow. inside. This is a pink oyster. They're very aggressive. See, the little mushrooms are already pinning.
Mm-hmm.
It's called pinning.
So how long does it stay in here?
So different mushrooms, they require different timelines.
Mm-hmm.
Some heavy mushrooms, they take about a month to 2 months to prepare for growth.
Okay.
And then we take into the fruiting room.
Okay.
This is the grain spawn. This is, for example, a pearl oyster that is ready for inoculation of the substrate. Where do mushrooms usually grow?
You don't know where mushrooms usually grow? What do we do all of last year in science class? Oh my goodness.
In the forest or in
dark damp places
next to a tree, or you know, there's over 10,000 species of mushrooms, and we identified about about 1,000 that are edible.
Oh yeah,
well, but
out of the known 10,000,
yeah, 100 that we can cultivate ourselves
without
mimic nature in a closed conditions.
Yep.
And they begin to grow as long as it's perfect conditions.
Gotcha.
A little bit different in conditions, it might not grow.
Gotcha.
At all. The unique thing about mushrooms, they're not plants.
Yeah.
They're fungus family. So mm-hmm. They breathe like us. They breathe oxygen and emit CO2. What do plants breathe? What do plants consume? Carbon dioxide. And they produce oxygen for us. The trees, they produce oxygen for us. Ah, you remember. Wait, did you see some mushrooms?
Yeah!
Alright.
This is called the fruiting process.
Fruiting, okay.
So in this phase, you can see the mushrooms on the right side, right there? You see? On the bottom, they're bursting through the bag. We make a little cut on the bag. The humidity inside is 90%.
Mm.
And the temperature is 61 degrees inside right now. These are chestnuts. You have oysters, black oysters, blue oysters. All right, here's more mushrooms. These are big ones. These are oyster mushrooms inside.
Yep, we'll pick you up.
I can see the
one. They're ready for harvest.
Oh, those guys are ready to go. This is a pretty impressive like climate control system.
Climate control. Air conditioning, humidifier, made it ourselves.
Oh, cool.
The piping.
Who's the engineer who put that together?
You too.
Very nice.
Yes.
You see, it's good for something.
Right, see, there's a huge positive pressure airflow coming in. Look at these mushrooms. These are king trumpets. And if you look down there, you see the chestnuts? Beautiful mushrooms over there. Look at that big one. You see that really big one?
Beautiful.
That's huge. It's called a reishi mushroom. It's very good for tea, producing tea, to create the anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer properties.
Very nice.
Very healthy stuff. It takes about 3 months to grow. Your bags are closed.
How many months?
Three months.
We just took them out from the tent because we have to clean. Every week we have to clean entire and sterilize each tent.
Mm-hmm.
So there's no contamination inside when we introduce the new mushrooms inside.
Awesome.
And then we have a community of people that come and pick up the used substrate that we grew mushrooms on, and they put it into the soils. So they make fertilizer, which is the mycelium begin to grow and help the other plants flourish. One of the most important elements of why I'm personally in this business is why and we as partners came together is because of food.
Right.
You know, we come from different backgrounds, different industries, but growing food is essential for us. So we started with the mushrooms because mushroom mycelium is the lifeline for all living things.
Mm-hmm.
They help decompose all the stuff that we see.
Yeah.
To prepare it for next consumption, for next life cycle.
Right.
Breaks it down so the nutrients can become useful.
Gotcha.
If I throw a piece of wood on the floor, another plant can consume it.
Right.
But the mushroom mycelium will break it down to basic components so all the other plants can consume it.
Beautiful. So now we're going to see some harvesting.
All right, our dear friend Firuz will bring us out a ready block and we'll be able to harvest it together.
That's it.
Died.
Oh
This is a giant.
Oh.
Serious guy. These are babies still.
Babies.
They still can continue to grow. This one is not ready yet, but look how beautiful it is. This is called a blue oyster.
Oh,
wow.
You can touch it. Right, just grab it and pull. Pull, pull, pull. There you go.
Whoa, look at that.
Hold it like this. There you go.
That's
nice. Nice.
This one. Yeah, you grab the whole thing. Oh, yeah, you gotta grab it from the bottom. This, you can eat the whole thing. From the bottom to the top.
Ooh.
The stem and the cap.
You can,
they can go as shallots type. You can cut up, you can cut it vertically, horizontally.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, when they're really big, you can do a steak out of it.
Wow.
You can grill it, make soup out of it. This is our robot Tammy. Tammy knows the entire facility. It can also follow and take notes for us and allow our virtual partners connect through Tammy and control it virtually. It's gonna follow you. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go, keep walking, it's gonna follow you. Tammy is following. Tammy is following Micah. Hey. We just harvested these.
Oh, that's, those are beautiful.
This is a fresh harvest of Mediterranean oyster. So, you see, this is the substrate.
Mm-hmm.
This is the mycelium inside, the white stuff. And the mushroom goes right from it. The purpose of a mushroom for the mycelium is to spread the spores further, to disseminate the spores for it to continue to process, produce, reproduce.
Right, okay.
The spores come out of these gills.
So it can continue to propagate?
Propagate, correct. And even under the cap inside, mycelium is still alive, because then we can take this portion and clone it.
Ah.
We can take it back into the petri dish and replicate it further. Mm-hmm. This will go to restaurants. This will go to retail stores once we prepare it properly, and that's it.
Beautiful.